home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making baklava.
Baklava and coffee is a great combination for evening dessert. But if you are not a coffee lover, you can enjoy this baklava itself anytime.
Now, baklava is not an Indian sweet, but I have learned a little bit and I'm going to share how easy it is to make and you can enjoy in no time. It is actually Greek dessert and Middle East people make it often because nuts and dry fruits are extensively used in Middle East cuisine. So this baklava is nothing but layer of phyllo pastry and mixture of nuts, dry fruit. It comes with variety of fillings and the shapes. Personally, to me, I like to make a baklava roll because it's much more easier than making squares or diamonds. But it's really your preference how you would like to make this baklava. So let's start. Here I have the phyllo pastry sheet. You're going to follow the direction on how to thaw and how you can use it. It comes with the instructions already. So I'm going to use just one. It comes in a 2-pack. Like this, and I'm just making today from one. Now when you work with this pastry, it's very delicate, so you have to work with a little patience here. But I'm going to and open only when you're ready to make. First I'm going to prepare this sugar syrup. I'm not going to boil it right now, but I'm going to just prepare it and put it on the side. So here I have the 1/2 cup of sugar and a little bit less than 1/2 cup of water. Always make sure that you take only enough water so that your sugar syrup doesn't take too long to get it ready. 1/2 cup sugar, water less than 1/2 cup, and the lime juice, fresh lime juice, just a little bit. Put this on the side, and now the filling. Now, as I said, a variety of fillings is used, and today I'm going to use the nut and the dry fruits. You can only make with the nuts, or you can only make with the dry fruits. It's really your preference. For the nut, I'm going to use the walnut. You can use any of your favorite nut, but walnut is traditionally walnut is used. And I have ground walnut. People who are allergic to nut can make this baklava with coconut and dry fruits. Make sure that the even bigger pieces of your nuts and the dry fruits, it's not bigger than lentil size. And I have these dry fruits, it's a cranberry and a mango. Mango is one of my favorite and I always try to look for the recipes that I can use the mango. Alright, so the ground walnut, dry fruits, brown sugar, cardamom powder, cinnamon powder, mix all dry ingredients. All dry ingredients mixed very well now, and I'm going to put this on a side. Here I have the butter, it's unsalted butter. Make sure it's a melted butter. There is no substitute for butter. You have to have this melted butter. You can use the butter flavor cooking spray, that's another option, but if you want to reach baklava, then this butter is must. Now it's time to open up this phyllo pastry and carefully take out and find the flat surface. I'm using this one of my cookie baking tray, and I'm going to put upside down, and this makes it easier to work for me. And to bake my baklava, I'm using today this pan. You can use anything that you have because this is the sturdy tray. It's a cake baking tray. So carefully I'm going to take out and unwrap this phyllo pastry, and make sure that you have your kitchen towel ready, because as soon as you open up, make sure that you keep it covered to avoid getting it dry, because once it gets dry it will tear apart easily. I have my kitchen towel here, and it's all already comes with this wrapped paper, so you can just put it on your surface down and use this to work. So take one at a time, keep this covered while I work with this one. Spread butter, take another sheet. I always use a double layer, but it's really your preference. So put the other one on top of. And again, brush with butter. Spread butter with your long hand like that to brush it quickly. All right, now it's time to put the mixture on these phyllo pastry sheets. So you can just sprinkle and then spread, and try to spread even. Now at the end, I keep just empty phyllo pastry. So you wanna seal it properly at the end. So keep some space without any nut mixture here, and roll from the short side. You can choose to roll from the long side, but this makes it easier to roll it from the short side. So just roll it, and you can again keep brushing the butter as much as you can. Okay, just good enough. Now keep the open side, this open end at the bottom like this, and you can also brush your edges very well like that. And don't forget to brush your lightly grease your pan as well. So I'm going to use the same butter here to lightly grease it all over, especially the bottom. It is very important step to keep brushing or keep using your butter while you make this baklava. Okay, good. And I'm going to put, I have already one roll here ready, and I'm going to place this into my pan here. And I'm going to finish my rest of the roll. Here I'm working on my last one. Here goes in. Don't forget to brush on the top as well. Keep it moisture as much as possible. Now I'm going to show you one with the butter flavor cooking spray. Shake it and take one pastry at a time. Spray your phyllo sheets. So if you think that spreading butter is a bit of headache for you, you can use just this butter and spray. Makes much easier. Spray. And the mixture of the nut. Now when I start making my last one, I turn on my oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. So my oven is already preheating. Should be ready in about 4 minutes. And start rolling. And all you have to do is just keep spraying. That ready to go into the plate here. That was the last one. Goes in. Again, spray on the edges and everywhere on the top and everywhere. And this tray is ready to go into the oven. Now make sure to put your unused portion of phyllo pastry again into the refrigerator. You can. And I have noticed one thing with my kids, that they are more excited about baklava when it is made in a roll and not square or diamond or any other shapes. One is ready, so ready to go into the oven. Preheated 350 degrees Fahrenheit, and make sure to put it in the center because we don't want to burn our phyllo pastries. So, and it's very delicate, so you want to make sure that you put it on a center rack like that. And it takes about 45 minutes to bake, but after half an hour, once I pass the half an hour, I keep close eye on it. And you want to do the same thing. Now again, coming back to the sugar syrup, turn on the stove on a high heat in the beginning, and then once it comes to the boil, you want to bring it down your temperature on a medium heat. So I'm going to turn on the stove. Now this traditionally sugar syrup is made with honey. Honey is added to the sugar syrup, but today I'm just going to make this simple Indian style sugar syrup. And only thing I add is the rose water. I have the rose essence here. That's the only thing that I add in my syrup. And to garnish my baklava, I have here the slivered pistachio. Let's check the sugar syrup. Because it's a very small amount, it comes to the boil faster. So at this point, I bring down the temperature on a medium heat and again simmer it for about 10 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes. Sugar syrup is about to get ready. At this point, I add my rose water. You can find this rose syrup in Middle East stores, or you can also find at Indian grocers. And this brings a nice aroma and the flavor. Syrup is ready. Turn off the stove. My baklava is ready. Nice golden brown color. Let me show you. Turn off the oven. Nice brown color. Look at the color. Love it. Now I want to let it cool down a little bit. It should be at the temperature of around warm temperature of the baklava. And my sugar syrup already ready. And then also I prefer just warm enough. You don't have to have the hot sugar syrup. Make sure that both of them are at the right temperature, just warm. Now before that, I'm going to cut it in half. Now if you prefer the square or diamond, even with this roll, you can make even the square or the diamond shape. I'm using this to cut mine. Let's see if it's the bottom. How does that look like? It's crunchy already, so it's good. And I'm going to cut. The reason to cut your baklava before you glaze with the sugar syrup is that the sugar syrup absorbs very well in the baklava. That's the reason that you want to cut it before you pour your sugar syrup. Look at this. Isn't that looks gorgeous? Now the baklava is warm enough and the sugar syrup both. So I'm going to pour this on the baklava. Actually, for my mother-in-law, I'm going to take out without sugar syrup. Look how easily it absorbs all the sugar syrup. Now on the top, you garnish the pistachio, but I kind of like to garnish with the powdered pistachio and almond. You can use the slivered almond if you want to. So just sprinkle on the top and the pistachio. Press a little bit so that it gets in with the sugar syrup. So when you eat, it doesn't fall apart, just like that. And I'm going to bring this onto the serving plate. I'm going to give it a bite. Crunchy and best time to eat. So this was all about the baklava. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you real soon with the next great recipe.